In this video, I'm gonna show you a quick tip from my podcast interview with Andrew Scheps, where he teaches you how to mix bass using the Omni Channel plugin from Waves. So get ready to rock. Hey Rockstars, my name is Lidge Shaw and welcome to Recording Studio Rockstars. If this is your first time here and you want to learn how to record, edit, mix, and master your best record ever, make sure to hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any videos from us here. And also, sign up for my free mixing course with the link below at mixmasterbundle.com. If you love talking about music and you love talking about making records in the studio, then you're gonna love checking out my podcast, Recording Studio Rockstars, where I interview weekly producers, engineers, mixers, songwriters, musicians, all about how they make great records in the studio. One of my most popular episodes to date was my interview with Andrew Scheps, who's a fantastic teacher, has an incredible discography and track record in the studio. On the podcast, he also talked about how he has transitioned from mixing traditionally in the studio on a console to mixing directly in a laptop with nothing but a pair of headphones on. And it's really empowering because it just means that essentially, no matter where you are, whether you're in a home studio, whether you're traveling, whether you're in a pro studio, it's possible for you to mix great sounding records using your DAW, mixing inside Pro Tools, using various plugins to mix with, including his plugin, Andrew Scheps' Omni Channel from Waves. And so in this episode, he talked about ways to mix the bass and make sure that the low end on your record and on your mix sounds fantastic and doesn't sound like a mess. Low end can be one of the biggest struggles for us in the studio, and it's one of the first challenges that you have to figure out when you're trying to make great sounding records. So check out this clip from Andrew Scheps, and I hope you enjoy it. All right, so here's another record that you did. Black Sabbath 13 was on, had some really great sounding, I'd almost describe it as like 3D bass. And I wondered if you want to talk about how we can create more depth when we mix bass.
Well, again, I mean, the source on that was amazing. That was a track by Greg Fiddleman, and he's amazing, and Geezer's ridiculous. So if you start with a great bass player playing a great bass through a great bass rig, and then that's a lot of your job done. But I think the biggest thing is to make sure that you don't have other things interfering with the bass. Like, it's really easy to say, man, I want the drum room to have a bunch of low end on it because that's going to sound super cool. And I want the thump on the guitars to be massive. So you really hear when they do hand mutes, like the bloom on the cabinet and all that kind of stuff. But that's where the bass is. So if you want the bass to rule, let it rule and then see what else fits. I think that's the main thing. If you've got a decent recording of a bass and you just make it loud and give it enough low end, as long as you don't start trying to fit other things in where it already is, it's going to work.
I think that's cool and I like that. If you want the bass to rule, let it rule.
And let it rule first.
And I remember the first time I heard somebody suggest something similar about the kick drum and the bass, saying, you know, there isn't really room. It's sort of like a small Western ghost town. You know, there isn't room in this town for both of us. You sometimes have to realize that you're going to have to let one of those two speak a lot in a certain area of the low end, and they can't both try and fill it all up.
Yeah, I mean, and there are tricks you can use. I mean, there's like in EDM, sidechain compression of the bass with the kick drum sort of thing. But you can do that with acoustic instruments too. Like, one of the reasons the de-esser is full frequency is because you can put an external sidechain into it. So if you put a de-esser at, let's say, I don't know, 80 hertz, 60 hertz on the bass, but trigger it with the kick drum, it'll only suck a little bit of low end out of the bass every time the kick happens. Now, that might be terrible because you're going to lose the attack when they're playing together, but it might also be that you really want the character of the low end of the kick drum whenever the kick drum plays, but you don't want the kick drum to rule the low end because it doesn't play all the time and you need the slab of low end energy. So there are ways to make it happen.
And that's cool that you brought that up. I was just about to ask you that because I remember you talking about that. And Rockstars, you're referring to the Omni Channel plugin has this sidechain feature to the de-essing, which is really cool. And again, that reason why you can sweep down into the lower frequencies, and it could be useful there as well.
Yeah, especially because if you've got, let's say, I mean, the example I gave in that video was like an EDM track, so you've got a real buzzy bass. But let's say you've just got a distorted rock bass and you can't feel the kick drum enough. You can poke a hole in the bass only in the low end, and humans aren't going to notice that, because if that mid-range buzz is still there from the distorted bass, you won't think the bass went away. But if you sidechain compress it, it will actually duck out, and that can be distracting.
Right, and then you can, because of the sidechain de-essing, it's going to, as the kick transient comes forward in the, with the kick's low end, it's going to move the bass out of the way in the low frequency a little bit, just to make room for it, and then comes back in. So you will hear that. You'll hear the effect of hearing the kick drum.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
I mean, and it doesn't work nearly as often as I would like it to, because in my head it's such a great concept, but, you know, every once in a while it's genius.
You know, that reminds me, it's one of the things about why it's so great to share so many how-tos in the world of recording, is because it doesn't mean that a particular how-to that somebody shares with me right in this moment is going to exactly work for what I'm trying to do. But I love that learning any new thing means I can get excited about going to my studio and trying that out, and I'm going to discover something for sure. You know, I'm going to learn just by through the act of trying something.
Yeah, yeah. And this goes back to the very first thing we were talking about. If you don't understand exactly how de-essers work and how external sidechains work, you'll never come up with anything like that.
Thanks for watching that. I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you want the bass to rule, and let it rule first. Thanks also to Andrew Scheps for joining us on Recording Studio Rockstars. Rockstars, if you want to take your mixing to the next level and learn more of the ways that I would approach a record and mix it and get it to sound radio ready and get a pro mix using nothing but simple free plugins, then please remember to sign up for Mixmaster Bundle. The link is right below in this video. That's my free mixing course that will show you how to mix inside Pro Tools using free plugins. This would work for you if you were in Logic, Studio One, anything else, Reaper as well. Hope you guys enjoy it. We'll see you guys around in the next video. Please remember to subscribe and like this video. Let us know if you think that Andrew's mixing tip would help you out in the studio in the comments below, or tell us one of your favorite ways to mix bass. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Cheers.